Here we go once again with another episode of Cosmic Debris. I am one of your hosts, as always, Andy George, my partner in crime.
Why do I get the shitty sound? TJ, better known as the jerk, and I'm going to be a jerk. You get the da-da-da-da, and I get the...
That's part of the shtick, my friend. That's part of the shtick.
All right, well, next week we're going to change the stick
out. Is that what's going to happen? We're going to change
the
stick.
I'm all fucking control that thing and put on a fart. Oh, the fart sound for you.
Let me see. I can give you the bell as your introduction, but...
Okay, well, that's
a little bit of a crocodile.
Jesus.
Oh, shit. How you doing today, brother?
I'm okay. I'm doing all right. I'm doing better. Had some issues last week.
Yeah, I know you had it. Some illness issues, man, from your medication that fucked you up.
Yeah, it did fuck me up more than I thought it would.
Yeah.
Yeah, whatever.
Yeah, but you're getting better. You sound better.
Yeah, it is definitely getting better. I'm not fucking freaking out like I was last week.
Yeah, I know. I called you a couple times on Friday. I'm like, oh, the fucker didn't answer the phone. I better go down and see if his fucking dead carcass is on the floor. But you weren't.
I think it was on Thursday. It was like, fuck, man, I want to die now.
Yeah, I know. You were. Yeah, when I talked
to you, fucking bad.
You were in bad shape. But yeah, you pulled through, dude, and you're on the mend.
Oh, fuck that. Yeah.
Oh, fuck that. I'm just a grumpy old bastard.
How are you doing?
I'm doing well, man. I'm doing well. My wife's mother's in the hospital, the last stages of life. So it was kind of a rough weekend, but, all we can do is pray that it happens pretty shortly here.
I know your wife and your daughter went to go visit her.
Yeah, they went up to see her. It was rough for my wife and my daughter to see her like that. But I said, it's the end stages of life, and hopefully, she's in a comfort care section of the hospital right now, and hopefully she will pass within the next couple of days. Yeah. So, and that's a good thing.
No, it is. When quality of life, our quality of life gets to a point where it's, it's really not going to get any better.
No, it's not going to get any better. So, now we're just praying that she passes real quickly. But other than that, things are good.
Good.
Yeah. Okay. So let's get on with the show. I'm back. Yeah, we had to delay our broadcast for a day, as we wait around for some news. But
we did delay for a day.
So, we're talking about some crazy shit in the news here, you and I, this morning.
Oh, yeah. It was, I was looking up some of the weirdest shit. And the funny one that really caught my eye was in Florida. The police in Florida said they captured a lemur spotted wandering loose in a neighborhood.
Yeah.
But another of the primates is still at large.
Still at large and on the run.
Yeah, and on the run.
We got an APB out for a fucking lemur.
It's still at large. What fucking police talk is that? Not that, one is still out there. We need to work on it. They're still at large.
Still at large.
We're going to shoot him.
The first one must have put his hands up. Don't shoot me. I'm a lemur.
Oh, leave the poor lemurs alone. Really, what are lemurs dangerous?
No.
No.
No, they're great fucking climbers, though. They're probably the best climbing primate.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, they live on that, only on that island of Madagascar. That's the only place you can find lemurs.
That's right.
And, of course, at the zoo. Yeah.
Except at the zoos.
Yeah. And we have a nice lemur collection down here at the zoo.
We do.
Yeah, we
I've
do.
I've been there many times. Yeah. Really a lot of good-looking lemurs.
Yeah. Speaking of that, they caught a man taking up skirt videos. Claims he was just testing his camera. Was that you?
Well, you would think so, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
No, upskirt cameras. How does that...
Upskirt videos. So what I'm talking... it was just something in the news that I see.
You have something taped on his feet?
No. It showed, pictures of girls leaning over a rail and he'd be shooting, when they're bent over.
Like he'd put his hands down.
I'm not, they didn't show any of that. I'm like, okay, so show me some of these so I can judge them.
I know.
It's well, like.
I want to know how he's getting away with it. We've always did the tape a mirror to the top of your shoe kind of thing.
Oh my God, you are a perv. So I don't know if I ever told you the story.
I never did it, but it was
Yeah, it was
on
back
my
in
list.
1999. I'm traveling around the country. I'm doing hardware and software upgrades for a hardware store. So I was down in Florida for about 2 weeks, and I would always take my camera.
You should look for that lemur.
Yeah, I could look for that lemur while I was down there. But I took some pictures from my balcony, looking down on these girls sunbathing down at the pool.
But they still had
clothes, yeah. And then I took some pictures of a bunch of girls in bikinis at a beach in Tampa. And my wife seen the pictures. She said, what are these? I said, oh, Steve Russell just wanted me to take those for him. He was my boss at the time. I said, oh, they were for Steve, man. It got nothing to do with me.
Nothing to do with
me. She said, well, what are you doing? I said, hey, I was testing out the film and the camera. making excuses, man, for being a perv. Yeah, you know.
I'm not sure I'd waste my film on already clothed.
It was nice. There were actually a few of them were playing volleyball.
Have you ever been to a nude beach?
Let's see, Black's Beach, I think, up in the San Francisco. I think that's Black's Beach, or is that the one down here?
Down here.
Okay, there's one up outside of San Francisco. Yeah, that there's a nude beach up there. I've been there one time. Really high at the time.
Were you?
Shit, yeah.
Well, I've been to the one down here a couple times.
Yeah. Did you take your pants off?
Fuck no. Are you kidding me? Nobody would want to see my shit. But so, I'll tell you, all the people that I think there was like, it was in the summertime. Yeah. And there was probably between sunbathers. There was a thing with a dolphin that got, I'll get in that in a second. But anyways, you know, probably about 50 people all together.
Yeah.
And there was probably only really one good looking woman.
Yeah, it's like, oh, man.
The rest are just saggy and fat. Floppy and
yeah, it's like, oh my gosh.
So
yeah.
We go there. I go down, you know, we're walking there from a lower beach.
Yeah.
Walk up and there's this poor dolphin that had beached itself.
Oh, no shit.
So all these people nude are out there trying to help this dolphin get back in the water.
It's just rolling its eyes
out.
They're
bending over and their saggy tits hanging on this poor dolphin. I'd be like, fucking kill me.
Be like, hey, slap me with them titties, baby. I'll get back in the water. Dolphins rolling.
Well, you know what
eyes.
Happened down here at SeaWorld one year, right? Well, there's been some incidences where the killer whales have trapped one of the trainers down at the bottom,
yeah.
Right? Or something like that. Well, there was one. This was probably about 30 years ago. One of the female trainers, they would always ride the dolphin in the dolphin show and stuff. And they train. They get on the back of the killer whale. And they'd have their wetsuits on. They'd be riding the thing. Well, this one time, one of the female trainers just had her like bathing suit on, bikini, bare legs and stuff.
Yeah.
Got on the back of the whale, and the whale dug it so much.
He got all boned up.
When she tried to get off, he bit her.
Oh no shit!
Fucking ripped her leg up and shit.
Oh,
trying
nice.
To like, don't leave.
Don't leave, baby. Hey man, show me some more of that. Yeah, I'm getting tired of looking killer whale.
That's
killer
crazy.
Whale pussy. Yeah.
I mean, but it was a mammal.
Yeah, there you go. Hey, I was reading a story about a guy who was working at this location. His wife would always make him these sandwiches for lunch.
Okay.
Okay. And then at some point he said, hey, could you make me two sandwiches for lunch? You know, they were struggling financially and stuff, so instead of him going out to buy lunch, she was making him sandwiches. Well, he invited one of his coworkers over one time for dinner, and they were sitting around just having some conversation, and the guy, the coworker says, hey, you know, I like the sandwiches that you make, but they're a little expensive. So the guy was taking his wife's sandwiches and selling them and then going out and buying junk food. I asked my wife, would that piss you off? She said, yeah, probably. I said, well, it's a good thing you never made me any lunch.
Pretty good.
Yeah, I'm like, hey, so I was reading another story about a passenger survives being hit in the head by a turtle. And this happened in Florida on Interstate 95. A 71-year-old woman who was riding with her daughter on Interstate 95 suffered a gash in her forehead when a turtle smashed through her windshield of their car.
How the fuck did the turtle get high enough?
So apparently they're thinking that somebody must have hit the turtle in front of them, flipped it up, and it came through their windshield and gashed the lady in the head. But it says they released the turtle back into the wild.
It's not on the run.
So
was it a turtle or a tortoise?
It's a turtle.
So it was a sea turtle.
Okay, it was a tortoise apparently, because there's a lot of, you know, a lot of box turtles and other turtles across the road down in Florida. But
if they live in the water, they're turtles. If they're, you know, well, okay, fuck it.
Oh, here we go with the science lesson. Here we go, Mr. Bill.
All right.
plan will be used against you.
It will be used against you. It will be used up again.
Against you. Excuse me. Hey, you know, Ted Nugent got the COVID.
Good.
Because he was one of them, you know, he didn't believe in, you know, he was dismissing the COVID-19 scare. But then Terrible Ted got COVID, and he said, oh, man, I got really sick over this. Ted, I guess you'll get your shot now.
Yeah, you fucking NRA fucking Nazi.
I like Ted.
He's a dick.
Yeah, Terrible Ted. Hey, there was a gender reveal party. You know, these kids today. Got to reveal the gender of their, you know...
The baby's
going to be born through these big, elaborate fucking parties. This one couple set off 80 pounds of explosives.
80 pounds of explosives?
80 pounds worth of explosives. And it said it rocked the town. People thought it was an earthquake. And it damaged some few homes in the area.
So were the explosives blue or pink?
No, the guy apparently was a... Yeah, I forget what the gender was. I didn't really care, but I thought it was funny.
About the explosives.
That they set off this huge fucking bomb. You know, just to reveal their kid being born. Well, hopefully now you get sued and you got to pay for these fucking damages. Because the guy owned a construction company or something. They set it off in his, you know, like parking lot or something.
That is bizarre.
But I got a couple other stories about that. There was an Iowa woman who died after being hit in the head by debris. And it was a piece of metal. And they created this little bomb to explode to reveal the gender. And it was like a pipe bomb. Could you imagine going to this baby gender reveal and fucking dying? From a pipe bomb. It's like, man, it proves how big an idiots we are. We want to celebrate all these things. It's like, okay, man, let's have this big reveal party. You know, who really gives a fuck? Give me a call when your kid comes into the world and we'll buy him something.
You know, we talked about this early in our season last year about...
Right.
You know, the money people spend on kids' birthday parties.
Yeah, all this extravagant shit.
Extravaganza, this whoop-de-doo.
Taco cart,
you know, yeah. Magician, juggler, face painter, all this shit. And people got to outdo each other.
That's it. It's just an outdo thing.
It comes down to the same fucking thing. Oh, look, yeah, the me. Big thing now is a gender reveal party.
I know.
Let me make mine the greatest, biggest ever.
And put it up somebody. On, yeah, and kill somebody. Well, there was an Arizona Border Patrol agent who accidentally started a wildfire. They're looking for you, dude.
I know.
You know, when he fired off his high-velocity firearm at a target.
And
it was supposed to release blue or pink powder.
Oh, my God.
However, the hit caused an explosion that... started a fire. It started the sawmill fire in Arizona. It burned 45,000 acres and caused $8 million in damages. What the fuck? That's just fucking crazy.
That was his best thinking for the day.
That was his best thing. You know, we always talk about our best thinking got us to where we are now. There was another one I thought was funny, and I saw this video. A guy shoots off an air cannon to, you know, shoot out blue or pink smoke, but the recoil from the cannon goes back and smacks him right in the fucking nuts. Dude, that was funny. And of course, everybody's got their phones out, and they put this shit right up on social media.
Oh, hell yeah. That's funny stuff.
Yeah, I just like, holy shit, man. That was crazy to me. It was like
Johnny Knoxville. And you know,
oh, yeah, it was jackass shit.
That is some pretty jackass shit getting nuts by him.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Explosive of sorts.
Yeah, I mean, them gender reveal parties.
I was thinking about doing that. I didn't tell you this.
Oh, jeez. Here we go.
You come over, and before the show, you smoke a cigar.
Right.
Going to get you to come over and tell you, why don't you bring over your biggest, fattest cigar?
Okay.
And then when you go in the bathroom, I'll take that cigar. I'll take one of my black cats.
Oh, I know. You still got the fire. Yeah, you
fucking shove it in the end like those. Do you remember those loads?
Yeah, yeah.
Put it in cigarettes?
Yeah, so here, let me blow your face up.
Instead of a load, I'll put it in a firecracker.
What a douche.
You'd be smoking it.
You'd be like, oh, fuck. Yeah, I'm blind. Oh, that was funny. You know, as kids, we used to do stupid shit to each other and think it was funny. Yeah, that's.
Well, they didn't mean to put out his eye.
Yeah, oh, no, shit, man, I put out his eye. My mom always said you put somebody's eye out with that. So I was reading some stuff about buffets, you know, are buffets a thing of the past, you know, where you go in and get all you want to eat?
Well, a lot of them have closed. There was the Soup Plantation.
Soup Plantation's out
Hometown of Buffet.
I haven't seen the... I mean, they opened up a Golden Corral down here about 3 years ago. It was doing really good business. But, you know, the past year and a half, it's been shut down. Chinese food buffets are gone.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I used to like to eat there every once in a while.
I used to love going to buffets before my surgeries and stuff.
Right.
Because I, you know,
I enjoyed eating.
Oh yeah, I enjoyed eating a lot.
Yeah,
and then watching people, fucking pocket stuff.
Oh yeah, we talked about that. I've been known to do that way back when. You take like a Ziploc bag in with me last week. They're closed. You know, chicken wings and what else? You know, Chinese food buffet. Throwing some egg rolls and some foil wrapped chicken. And shit like that. It's like,
well, it's a little bit harder to steal Chinese food like that. I mean,
well, not if you got a Ziploc.
Well, no, but you have to go up there and pan it in, and or bring it back to your table and scoop it into a Ziploc, throw it in your jacket somehow.
Yeah, I would do that.
I think I've taken some fried chicken, but I didn't have a bag, and just put it in my pocket.
That was lint chicken.
Hey, what's that greasy pocket thing happening? I don't know.
Yeah.
I didn't wash my clothes.
Yeah, no shit. But I was reading some stories about things people have seen at the buffet line. And this one person saying they saw three little girls step in front of them before they went to the chocolate fountain. Okay, and then the girls have their hands in the chocolate fountain. And their parents just sat there and laughed. They thought it was funny.
Oh, that's gross.
That's fucked up.
They have those kind of things at the casinos here.
Yeah.
They have a lot of those, like, we'll have a fountain, and you take a pick of strawberry up and stick
right,
it in
stick
there.
Right, stick it in there, yeah. You didn't just go, like, put your mouth in there.
Put your whole head in there.
Yeah. But there was another one, and one of these was pretty funny. A person was witnessed at a soft-serve ice cream machine when an older woman got in front of her and couldn't turn on the ice cream machine. She, like, jiggled and shook it, tried to turn it each way. And so this old lady thought her next logical step was to put her lips around the thing and try sucking the ice cream out. Who she
Kamala
thinks she was,
would be good at sucking it out.
Kamala, yeah, no shit. Oh, shit. Yeah, I thought, oh, man, that's pretty disgusting.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, and then there was one where a guy watched, a person observed another person at the soup thing. And the guy picked up the ladle and just zipped off the ladle and then didn't like it, spit it back in the pot.
Oh, that's
putting the ladle back in.
That is, somebody would actually do that?
No, dude.
I guess he's sipping it and putting the ladle back in, but spitting the shit back in.
Spitting the shit back in. Yeah. How disgusting is that, man?
That is gross.
Yeah, no shit.
That is gross.
But the last one here, a guy who worked at a buffet watched a man walk up to the buffet line without a plate. And he pulled his T-shirt out, you know, like a little,
right,
like an tray. Apron, yeah, like a tray, and filled it full of fucking chicken wings. It's like, dude, just go get a plate, you stupid fuck. I know.
Now, see, that's something I think I, you know,
yeah,
makes
so
sense.
Yeah, I mean,
he's not hurting anybody else.
No, he's not. It's just like, dude, you're a fucking slob. But the one I thought was funny was, you know, these people went in there because you could buy containers full of food.
What?
You know, some of them you could go in and, you know, buy food to take out. You just weigh it and you pay by the pound.
Okay. Yeah, I got it.
So this guy took his mother to this buffet and they stopped to pick up a friend on the way. Mm-hmm. Okay, so they're going through the line filling up containers. But the guy they brought with them is in the line eating chicken wings and shit.
As they're scooping.
As they're
away.
Scooping things up. And I don't think he even had a container. You know, and it's like a guy come up, you know, a guy pointed out to his mom, hey, look what Jimmy's doing back there. You know, he's just eating shit out of the fucking line.
You know how you solve that? Person comes into the restaurant or into the establishment.
Yeah.
They get on a scale.
We pay by how much you leave when you,
how much you weigh when you leave. And there's no bathrooms in there.
Yeah, I know, because, you know, people stuff themselves, go throw up and come back and eat again. I'm like, what sense does that make? You got to feel like you get your money's worth?
Yeah, what happened at the end
of this story was, you know, the manager come up and says, hey, see what your friend is doing. So him and his mom paid for their shit, and they said, fuck, we're just leaving him behind. you know, and then you hear all this.
Sorry, they drove there. They picked him up on the way.
Yeah.
And they and now they're going to leave him in there and drive away.
Drive away, man. He just fucking left him because he's in there arguing with management. Well, everybody does it.
Every, you know, that's the biggest excuse in life.
Everybody else is doing it.
Yep.
Remember, you always hear that from your parents. Well, Jimmy jumped off the bridge. Would you?
Probably. Maybe.
I probably jumped off first.
Yeah. He would be Jimmy's mom saying, but Jimmy, Andy jumped off the bridge with you.
Well, Andy's a fucking retard.
Yeah, never follow a retard around.
That ain't no shit, dude. Hey, you know, I was reading a story, and this is actually a pretty cool story. You know, Earth Day was last week.
I heard that.
They got a technique that can turn all our old plastic back into a fossil fuel.
You mentioned that to me, and I'm like, how the... Okay.
They're going to melt it down, and because, I mean, all our plastics come from fossil fuels. They're basically
a
byproduct of our fossil fuels.
Right.
But they're working on this technique to turn that shit back into oil.
Huh.
How crazy is that? And they could do it now. The improvement on the technique where it used to be a really high temperature to melt it all back down.
Right.
But now they can do it at a lower temperature to extract that oil back out of it.
So what is left over after
they? You know, they didn't say that. I was wondering that. It's like, so what is left over? There's got to be
really
something.
Just adding chemicals into the oil,
right?
Or into the fossil fuel oil mixture gunk,
right?
To make it hard, they add chemicals. So what, do you just end up with chemicals?
Yeah, you know, I didn't go through the whole story as I'm stumbling here because, no, I don't know what the final leftover byproduct is.
Huh.
You know, there's got to be something left.
There's got to be something that's gross and toxic.
Yeah, I would think so. It's like, I just send it to Chernobyl.
Yeah.
Let's just ship it over and put
Actually,
it back.
Actually, that's what we should all do, make an arrangement with the Russian government.
Yeah.
That we take all of our nuclear waste and ship it and have it put in at Chernobyl,
yeah,
and then cover it up with concrete. And
that's all they did.
Let it all be there in one place in the world.
Yeah, it's like,
why
that,
not?
Because that's all they did, man.
Fucked up. I mean, there's nothing there.
You know, I was reading the story, and I'm like, wait a minute, and it didn't make sense to me that they were testing the people who were around Chernobyl to see if they had fucked up mutated kids.
Right.
You know, checking their DNA and their kids' DNA, and there was really no difference in their DNAs.
Right.
Most of them aren't mutants. You know, might have three-legged Jimmy.
Well, most of the people that were there had died
right.
within, you know, some months. You know, either almost within days if they got really close.
Right, if they were really close.
To, you know, months later, you know, the workers or people like the helicopter pilots that went over to dump, like, sand and concrete, they
right.
got fucked up.
Oh, yeah, yeah. But they're saying that now these people are reproducing, you know, some of them. Because it's been 35 years.
Did they rot their cocks off?
Yeah, 35 years since Chernobyl.
Yeah, that's about right.
Yeah, that's a long freaking time,
There was
man.
A show on HBO that was...
Chernobyl, yeah.
I watched it. It was really fucking good.
Man.
And it was all true. I mean, it was all based on the true stuff. It wasn't like a documentary, but...
But yeah, it was all like true events.
The people that got, you know, the leaders of the, you know, the plant and stuff like that that made these decisions.
Oh, yeah.
You know, they all ended up in the gulag. And one ended up in... what the fuck are you talking about?
I don't know. I was thinking about tacos.
I didn't even Russian music.
I was thinking about tacos.
I guess.
What are some tacos?
What's that place they say? Oh, it's a Siberia.
Yeah, yeah, like, take it to the gulag.
You're like that guy who has been opposing...
Oh, yeah, he's dead, man. He's on his deathbed.
Well, he's almost dead.
Yeah, he's way out there. But, yeah, I mean, I was just talking about the day. You know, that big floating... Yeah, I don't know why the fuck it keeps going. I thought I would turn it off. Yeah, they hauled out more than 47 tons of marine debris out of the Pacific Ocean. We talked about before.
Oh, yeah.
That floating pile of plastic, man.
And crap.
And crap, you know, old gill nets, they call them ghost nets, ocean plastics, you know, and they showed some pictures, and they were on
condoms.
My island, man. They were on Midway Atoll out there. They showed some pictures of it.
Really?
All the shit that, yeah, I imagine when I was there a lot
so
of
they
shit.
Hauled it in.
Yeah, they had it. Well, they brought it on different boats, but they were out on five or six different islands. You know, the last of the Hawaiian islands are really small atolls and islands way out there. You know, they're about 2,000 miles away from Honolulu, Oahu.
Okay.
You know, there's really small
and
islands.
They're putting that shit there.
No, they're going to take it back to Hawaii and they'll burn it for energy. They'll turn it into energy.
Huh.
You know, they still have fire plants that produce energy there.
Right.
But I mean, and that's just 47 tons ain't nothing compared to what's floating around out there.
Oh, no. Yeah.
I just thought, hey, good. And I just brought that up because they showed some pictures of, you know, Midway Island and Curry Island out there.
Well, you like Midway.
Yeah, man. It was a nice island back then, but now it's just like a junk pile. You know?
Yeah, that's the way you left it.
That ain't the way I left it, man. I left it there as a stinking drunk, so I don't know what the hell I left. So I end up as an alcoholic. No, I got to bring this up, because we're sitting here, we got a barrel of pretzels on our studio table.
Bring out the pretzels.
Yeah, bring out the pretzels. And my brother sent me a picture, and he shows me two barrels of those. He says, hey, I get two of these delivered every month. Thanks for getting me addicted, just like you did to the Bearcats we used to take. And we used to call Bearcats, it's a mescaline.
Oh, my God.
We used to do a lot of it. He said, yeah, thanks for turning me into an addict.
Yes.
Yeah, I said back, I just sent my mom some pretzel money so she could send me some good pretzels.
Yeah, it's not my fault for ordering barrels every week or whatever, but it's your fault for getting me addicted.
Yeah, you got me addicted. Yeah, I know. You know, you got to blame somebody else for our addiction.
Always.
So, you know, there are some brands out there, you know, like, you know, we talk about Taco Bell and Burger King and stuff.
We do.
You know, that have, well, yeah, it just come up. So shut the fuck up and play along. My gosh, dude.
My show.
How long we've been doing it? This is my fucking show, you know, just go along with it. You know, how about slogans for brands that are brutally honest?
Like Taco Bell, only 20% meat.
Yeah, or Benadryl. You have allergies? Just sleep it off. Netflix, pay us $12 a month to spend an hour trying to pick something to watch before we fall asleep. There's another one. Lay's potato chips. Who says you can't charge for air?
Yeah, right?
You know, Activia. Have you shit yourself today? I thought that was a good one, man.
You're gonna make me sure.
You know, and then the one there's one for Denny's.
For what?
From Denny's, where you're either having your 4 o'clock drunk meal or Sunday brunch with your grandparents.
Yeah, that's pretty much.
How many times have you fucked up and end up at Denny's?
My fucking brother loves going to Denny's.
Denny's, yeah.
Jesus,
used to be a cheap Grand Slam, man.
Yeah. But it's, you know, it's Waffle House.
Yeah, dude, we ate some at some Waffle Houses on our trip. The little Waffle House. Oh, man. Yeah, they're just a little shithole in the walls, man.
They are, but.
Yeah, I mean, it's not bad. You know, they serve a purpose for us drugs. Hey, so, when you go on a trip, do you forget to pack shit?
Usually, always.
Yeah, what's the worst thing you forgot to pack for yourself?
Jesus. I don't know. You should ask me an hour ago. Give me time to think about it.
Well, this is on the spot. This
probably underwear.
There you go, underwear. I know I went away from my wife for a weekend. I think we went up to Big Bear one time. I packed all these other accoutrements for a nice weekend. Didn't forget my drugs. But I forgot to pack underwear.
Yeah, I've forgotten to pack underwear.
It's like, oh, man, I got to go to the store and buy some damn underwear, man. But you always forget something on a trip, and it's like, oh, I end up with more shit coming back than I did when I left.
Always.
Yeah, it's like, oh, you always got to go pick a toothbrush, a razor, or shaving cream, or some shit like that.
Where you end up, you're at some place that you condoms. Go to that you have to go to, like, their gifts shop.
And yeah.
You pay five times more for
yeah,
it.
It's like, hey, dude, it's a $1.29 tube of toothpaste you charged me $7 for. I'm like, son of a bitch.
Right?
That's just fucking crazy shit, man.
How about souvenirs? Go on a trip and
you gotta buy something for everybody in the family.
How many times have you bought shit at the airport coming back home, but you didn't buy stuff for the grandkids or the kids, and you're like, fuck, now I gotta get it at the airport.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Come
yeah,
on. Sometime. I bought a Detroit Red Wings hoodie
Yeah.
And I went back to Detroit, and I was going to go out to the stores locally, but then I'm like, fuck. I get to the airport, and it's like five times more than it should be costing.
Yeah,
than
it cost at fucking Walmart.
How bad do you want it?
Yeah, I know. It's like, oh, dude, I got to bring something back so I don't think I'm a fucking total loser. I'm a total fucking drug addict.
Oh, well, you don't want them to think that, but basically.
Yeah, basically, I was really high at the time. Didn't really think about you to the last fucking minute.
No,
yeah,
always.
We always buy.
Didn't you think about me?
Not really. I was having fun.
there's no good answer.
No,
to
that's one of them. That's one of them questions you just best leave unanswered. Shit.
If you can. But.
Yeah, no, it's like, yeah, some people keep digging. And, they got to get an answer. So I got one more thing for today to talk about.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. So there was this senator in Oklahoma, and they were proposing a bill to ban paper straws.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. You know, now, so, what's the reasoning behind that?
I got no idea.
I can see banning plastic straws.
Yeah, I don't know why they're, you know, banning about a bill, yeah, proposing to ban paper straws. And the guy says, well, you know, you can't use paper straws to drink a milkshake. But
yeah, they collapse.
Maybe Kamala could make it work because of her vast experience. And they fall apart and turn to mush quicker than Biden trying to string together a coherent sentence. And they collapse like Mitt Romney under the slightest amount of pressure. I thought that was funny, man. It's just like, you know, this is the state senator. They're giving them shit for saying that, man. It's like, how do you say that about the vice president?
If you go into public service and you're going to be on TV or you're going to be a national figure,
right,
you got to expect to be getting the shit.
Oh, yeah. You're going to step in shit, man.
You know, like Ted Cruz, he's like, you know, Dracula, looks like Dracula with his haircut and shit.
Yeah, and it's like
all kinds of weird ass shit.
Oh, yeah. You're going to be torn apart. So, yeah.
My favorite one is I think it was the 2012 election. And the Republican convention, wasn't that the one where Clint Eastwood comes out?
Oh,
He's talking to, like, nobody in a chair.
Oh, yeah. Spring free and demented Clint out.
You're like, what the fuck is this shit?
Yeah, this was a good move.
Or how about when, you know, during Hillary's thing, right? At the very end, they give her the nomination. And Bill Clinton comes out there with them and all these balloons, and he's just playing with the fucking balloons.
He's like a cat.
What a fucking idiot.
He's like a cat just tapping the balloons right? around. I know, dude. That's crazy shit. Yeah, so don't bring out your demented one on your behalf.
Yeah. don't go out on stage with your idiots.
Yeah, if that's what you... Yeah, here, help endorse me. Yeah. All right, dude, so I think we'll wrap it up for today, man, and give this... give this shit show a flush. And we'll get together again next week and talk some crazy shit. All right, dude.
Have a good one.
Have a good one later. Share the love, man. Peace. This is Andy George from Cosmic Debris. Hey, I wanted to let you know you can reach us by email at cosmic.debris.2020@gmail.com. So if you have any comments or anything you'd like to hear us talk about, please email us at cosmic.debris.2020@gmail.com, and we'll ignore most of your stuff. Hey, if you got any pictures out there you'd like to share with us, we'd sure like to see them. You can also follow us on Twitter at Andy Jerk. So, hey, send us a message, send us an email. We love to hear from our fans. You guys have a blessed day, and we'll catch you next show. Later.